My name is Amir Amirani. The premise of the film, We Are Many, is the story of the biggest demonstration in history, which happened on the 15th of February 2003, when 30 million people around the world demonstrated to try and stop the Iraq war. And here in London, it was about 2 million people, and it was the largest protest in the history of the United Kingdom. Well, it was just the size of it. There had been nothing like it in history. And also, it was so big, and yet the war went ahead. And I think people felt very, very strongly. They felt so strongly that the biggest number of people ever came out. So I felt that for a filmmaker, it was a story on its own merit that needed to be told, the biggest event like it in history, but also the fact that the war went ahead despite it. So I felt that was a story that needed to be told. Obviously, the film recognizes that the protest didn't stop the war, but it also goes on to show that it had impacts that we weren't aware of at the time and couldn't have been aware of. So we show that actually it had an impact in inspiring the Egyptian movement for democracy, which then flowered years later into the Egyptian revolution. It also goes on to show that when the government here wanted to have a war on Syria, the vote was defeated. And a lot of that has to do with the change of mood in the country, thanks to that huge demonstration. But also, I think it's arguable that the war could never have been stopped, even with that many people, because we now know that it was planned at least a year or so in advance. So the film deals head on with the fact that it didn't stop the war, but it goes on to show that it had other impacts. I filmed in 7 countries around the world. The event actually happened in 72 countries around the world, in nearly 800 cities. So I chose 7 countries to show the kind of variety. So it was Australia, it was Sweden, it was America, it was the UK, it was Spain, Italy and Egypt. We even interviewed some people who had done the demonstration in Antarctica. I tried to choose people who were, you know, either organizers of the demonstration or ordinary people who went on it, or indeed some of the high profile sort of people who went on it, from people like Brian Eno, Damon Albarn, Danny Glover, Ken Loach, Mark Rylance, the actor, even Richard Branson's family went on it. So it's, you know, it's an all-encompassing film that hopefully people will come and see.
For people who maybe wouldn't have agreed with this specific protest, would you say that there's still a value or an interest in them coming to see this film?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this film has no commentary. I'm not in it, so it's not trying to sell a particular kind of case. But it's showing the story of this big demonstration. And I think even people who were not on it or maybe don't agree it, I hope they will come and see it to see the kind of, you know, what it was that brought the biggest number of people in the history of this country out on the streets. I hope that they'll first of all see a film that they'll enjoy, but also see the story of that day in a new light. Because inevitably, most people who went on that demonstration, you know, will say, "Well, we went on it and it failed." But actually, what I want them to see is that it wasn't a failure; that it led to other very positive things. And I think people should take that message away: that it's not a waste of time to go out and demonstrate for things you truly believe in, because otherwise we lose our voice, and people need to remember that they have a voice, they have a power, and they can use it, which is why it's called We Are Many. It comes from the poem by Shelley, We Are Many, or it's called The Mask of Anarchy. So I'll do that again. So basically, people have to realize they do have power. We are many, and that line comes from a poem by Shelley, The Mask of Anarchy, and at the end he says, ye are many, they are few, and that's something we must remember. I mean, interestingly, that demonstration was organized in 2003 before social media. So it was before Twitter, it was before Facebook, I mean, it was email, but largely it was people meeting each other and organizing it through phone calls, through meetings, through emails and stuff like that. So, I mean, today, social media is prevalent and people do use it. But that huge historic demonstration actually happened without social media. In a way, it set the stage for the kind of movements that were to come. But today, that kind of, with social media, it's even easier. So we might even see bigger and bigger demonstrations. So tonight, The film is being shown simultaneously in 90 cinemas in 45 cities, 4 cinemas in Scotland, cinema in Ireland, in Wales, and all over the UK, and 22 cinemas in London. And then the Q&A from the host venue here, Curzon Mayfair, is being broadcast by satellite live to all those other cinemas. And we have a very exciting panel, which is going to be moderated by Jon Snow from Channel 4 News. And we have Damon Albarn, the actor Greg Wise. We have Philippe Sands, the barrister. We have Lindsay German from the Stop the War Coalition. And we have Omid Jalili, the actor and comedian who's one of the executive producers, and myself. So it's a very exciting panel, some very interesting people coming to the screening. So I think it'll be a very, very exciting, very enjoyable event. Documentaries are about real life that's going on around us. You know, traditionally in cinemas we're used to seeing fiction, and in the last few years documentaries are coming to the big screen, and I think there's a real hunger. As you say, there have been some high profile documentaries, you know, Senna, Man on Wire, and so on. And of course before that we've had the Michael Moore type films. So I think people want to come and enjoy these experiences in a group on the big screen. Some documentaries really do lend themselves to being on the big screen, and I think this too, you know, lends itself because it has such an epic scale to it. So, you know, I think there's a real hunger also amongst people to deal with these kinds of topics, which traditionally have been on television, but actually people, I think, do want to come to see them. As the films of Michael Moore show, people are very interested in these subjects.